Today, web browsers are expected to be able to render lots of different types of documents. So for example, you can open a PDF in your web browser, and the browser is expected to be able to do that. But web pages, HTML web pages, still really consist primarily of four key components. So what are those? Common parts of most web pages, the HTML markup that defines the structure of the page, images and other sort of rich media content that appear on the page, CSS, which defines, or cascading style sheets, which are used to define how the HTML should look, and then finally, JavaScript. JavaScript is a little piece of code that will come down. JavaScript is the language that's used to write little bits of code that come down with the web page that are allowed to modify it, interact with the user, and do a variety of things with the page. So let's see those four components in the context of a simple site. So here's the web page. Here's what's visible in my browser. So I went, in this case, to a particular URL, and here's the page as it was rendered by my browser. This is a page that has a picture of a cat. That's all there is. Now, I said four different elements, so let's look at each one of them in turn. Here is the HTML markup that was retrieved by the web browser. This is the first thing it did was it asked the server for this HTML document, and here's what it got back. And you can see that this document has quite a bit of structure. It's written in HTML markup. I'm certainly not going to go into what all these elements mean, but what these elements do is define various attributes of the page and then also define the content that's part of the page. So let me point out a few things. The title element that appears in the head part of the HTML is what's actually used by the browser to determine what to put up here on the tab. So you may have wondered, how does the browser know what to put, what to call the page in the tab? It uses this part of the HTML, this title component right here, a more complex page. That's why this tab is called a more complex page. If I go down a little bit lower, here's text that actually appears on the page itself. Now you might notice that the text looks different. This is pure text that was retrieved. Now on the page, not only are the line breaks different, right? The text is in a different font, it's in a slightly different color, so we'll come back to that in a second. But this is the raw text that appeared, and there's some information here that the HTML has about this is supposed to be a paragraph. So the paragraph starts here and ends here. This is part of the HTML markup language. And you can see, paragraph starts here, ends here, and there's a little bit of a break afterwards. So that's good. Second important part of the page is something that's called CSS, or cascading style sheets. And this is a Bootstrap CSS file. It was, part of the Bootstrap project. And what this does is, and this is a really long file, and I probably won't be able to even find the parts of it that are interesting, but what this does is it defines how elements on the page should look. So for example, how much space should there be after this paragraph before the beginning of the next paragraph? The HTML doesn't tell me that. The HTML just tells me that this text is part of a paragraph. It's the style sheet that actually dictates that. So let me see if I can show you that. If I click over here on my great web inspector, I can look. Here we go. So here's the paragraph. Let me zoom in here. This was pulled in from Chrome, used the style sheet to compute this, and this tells the browser how much space there should be around it. And so, for example, if I turn the margin off, then you'll see that the space above and below this gets a little bit different. And I can also use this to define that there should be no margin, right? So now I've changed the margins above and below the paragraph, and there's no margin below the paragraph, which is not really what I want. This is kind of how it came down. So this was the setting that was defined by the CSS, okay? Now, other parts of the page, the images. What would the web be without pictures? We'd love the web for that. So here's a picture, and this is a little hard to see, but this is the picture of a cat. It has its own URL. It was retrieved. In this case, it was actually retrieved from a different site. So I used a picture from Wikimedia as part of this sample page. This is a picture of a cat. It's really, it's even bigger than this, right? So it's actually quite a big image. But it was retrieved and it was used to render the page, right? This is the same picture that you see down here. Now, it's not the same size. So that's interesting. That's another place where the CSS comes in and the HTML. So the HTML and CSS essentially said, I want this picture on the page, but I want to put it here, and I want it to be this size. So, but this is the image that was actually used. Okay, finally, let's look at the JavaScript. And again, this is a huge piece of JavaScript. It's far too complicated to look into in detail. But that JavaScript runs when the page is loaded. And that JavaScript can do a variety of things. In this case, I don't think the JavaScript is actually doing much. But JavaScript can be used to make the page interactive. JavaScript can run requests in the background. So, but JavaScript is this really, really, really exciting and interesting part of the modern web, meaning that every time you retrieve a website, not only are you getting content and instructions about how the content should look, but your web browser is actually running a little piece of code. And in some cases, it's a huge piece of code. And JavaScript is really what powers the modern web, and it sort of explains and it powers a lot of things that you might notice about how the web works. So, four major components of the website: the HTML source, the CSS that defines how that HTML should look, images and other media content that are included as part of the page, and JavaScript code that runs when the page is loaded. Those are the four parts, four common parts of most web pages.